In a world where elves and men fight side by side, trolls and halflings form alliances, clerics and necromancers, wizards, and yes, even warriors can become united by EverQuest.
Hello, everybody. Happy Mondays. I'm Sirkin. Some of you may have known who that is. Some of you may not. I'm also joined by Bracknar this fine evening. Bracknar, say hello.
Hello.
Who are you?
I'm Bracknar. I'm the newest staff member on the server. Even though I've been around for since April? I don't feel very new anymore.
Well, we're very happy to have you here again tonight, sir. And we have a very other special guest tonight. You might know him as Micah Davith. I hope I said that right. And say hello. Tell these people who you are.
Hey, everybody. Yeah, it's Micah here. Micah Davith. That's my Twitch name. It's my game name and game also. What's going on, everybody?
Micah Davith. Davith. I said it wrong. I'm going to try. You know what? Look, I'm not going to be able to do it because I'm a dumb person. Oh, I can just type it. Look, guys, I'm sorry. You're going to have to deal with me typing, which means I'm not going to be paying attention. But I will talk the entire time that I am typing things out for you. My NVIDIA thing is ready for a driver update. Boom. Go there. Click on that. Follow this guy. Fall in love with the sweet, soothing sounds of his voice. Gyno, you're married. You cannot start hitting on Micah 2 minutes into this thing. That is just unacceptable, sir. Oh, Micah. Tell us a little bit about who you are. I know you stream. These people here might know you stream. You play EverQuest. Tell us a little bit more.
Well, first of all, thanks, Sir Ken, for inviting me onto the stream. I've watched many of them over the past few months when I first started here on Project 1999. I'm a streamer. That's how I started. I started a little over a year ago doing Minecraft, Battlefield 4, CS 1.6. Couple other games. And I'm still kicking myself in the butt for not having heard about this server, you know, years ago. I didn't even know P99 existed until around February of this year, 2015. I lurked on the forums for about a week.
How did you eventually find it? What was it that made you find it?
Word of mouth through gamer friends.
Okay, nice.
Just always reminiscing and talking about the good old days of EverQuest. And somebody said, hey, you know, there's a EverQuest emulator. I'm like, an EverQuest what?
So you're forum lurking?
Yeah, I was forum lurking. And then when I saw Velius was coming out, I was like, that's it. That was the clincher right there. Installed on February 13th, the day before Valentine's Day, much to my wife's chagrin. And Magnate, my best friend and pal, who's my cohort through all these adventures, helped me install it. And that's where I'm at. So only a few months on the server.
Did he used to stream as well?
He tried it out a little bit.
I think I actually caught one of your earlier streams where you guys were maybe both on it. And I think that is actually the first time I saw you streaming. I like to lurk a lot. I don't always say things, but I like to lurk on people's streams. And then once too many people start asking questions, I usually go away.
Yeah, I've had to curb a couple of people. Especially with Rogaine hanging out.
Yeah, I mean, this is going to sound bad. I don't mean this in a bad way, but like if we're on a Twitch page, odds are, A, we're probably doing something else as well. And so we don't want to answer some questions and miss other people's questions. But also, like, we're not there to be GMs, I guess. We're not there to be staff members. We're just there hanging out with the community. Like, if you bumped into me at a bar, you wouldn't be like, oh, Sirkin, it's so good I see you here. I got this item reimbursement petition I've been waiting on. Can you do that real quick? Can you just bust out the phone and make it a thing? Like, that's the wrong time and place to try and get CSR assistance. And I think it's disrespectful to the streamers themselves. I think it's in a way disrespectful to you and your channel for people to try and use your chat for CSR assistance.
Yeah, I've had to send a couple of messages to people, and I just put a disclaimer out to the guild. Hey, you know, it's their time. They're hanging out. Don't bug them. Blah, blah, blah. And hopefully people respect that.
Yeah, I think most people do. Most of them are good if you ask them to do something. So tell me about your leveling up experience. Were the zones empty? Were you forced to hunt in places you didn't want? Was there a lot of griefing? What was the leveling up experience, since yours is relatively recent? There might be new players on the fence about playing here, and your experience can help them, because other players that are usually on, they've been here for many years, and their leveling up experience of 2011 is not going to be anything close, probably, to what it was for you.
Yeah, and kind of what goes hand in hand with that is the community itself. When I first started here, you know, back in February, very first night or second night, I just started getting all this attention from people. One, because I was streaming, and two, everybody was just being so nice and so generous with advice and things I should do and where I should go. I took the path that I was familiar with back from 1999 when I first started playing EverQuest back in the day. I played from 99 to 2004, all the way up to Lost Dungeons of Norrath. But, and like I alluded to earlier, you know, Velius, that's the reason I came back, was because of Velius. Everything after Velius, you know, I feel the game kind of went downhill.
Did you play Classic and Kunark on live? Or when did you start playing live, I guess? What era of EQ did you play live?
Classic EQ before Kunark. Like a month or two before Kunark came out.
Okay. And was Velius your favorite?
Absolutely. Yeah. Velius was my favorite. And by the way, shout out to any Povar people out there.
Povar people, huh? Oh my god, I knew a kid. I met a kid in real life who played EverQuest. And he's the only human being I've ever met in real life that played. And he played on Povar. And, oh shit, he played a ranger. I can't remember his stupid name. Oh, but it was stupid. There was somebody else with that same name, but he was a well-known, like, across other servers player. And I thought it was shitty that he took that guy's name. Oh, so Velius.
Yeah, I used to main a cleric and a monk way back in the day. You know, pulling in Kale, you know, pulling those giants with my monk was just probably the best experience I've ever had playing in this game. Loved it.
Oh, I loved Velius. I loved all of Velius so much. I actually have a player account that I did beta testing on the Velius server with because of how much I loved it. We need to get the Velius beta server back up, by the way, guys. Guys, Rogan. That's who I mean by guys at this point. Because Noblog threw you under the bus, Rogan. He said that it's on you. So I can't blame Noblog anymore. Oh, Bracknar, I feel I've been leaving you out.
Oh, that's fine. I've this was my second run at this. I'm fine to sit in the back seat.
Yeah, I don't care about you anymore.
No, please. I was going to ask Mike if he's actually looking at his client, though, because I don't think he is.
Yeah, I am. I see you.
Oh, okay.
I saw you. You were there a second ago.
I'm sitting beside you guys now. That's why there's a crowd gathering below us.
Oh, I see you move now. I was in a different camera view.
Have you ever seen brooms while you were streaming?
Yes. Pissed me out. The stream was like, what the hell is that? I'm sure the people at Seb's Onan were freaking out. What the hell are these two brooms here?
We have a staff member who likes to do that to streamers, and I think it's the funniest thing in the world.
And it's not me.
No, it's neither of us. I don't want to give him away, but he might not even be pleased that I'm telling people it's a staff member doing it. But nobody really listens to these things, so it should be fine. Well, Bracknar, what about you? What was your favorite expansion, I guess, for EverQuest?
Oh, man. I played in the... Well, let's see if I can frame this. When I played, I really wasn't much of a gamer then. This was one of the first games I had played, so I actually wasn't paying very close attention to any expansions or eras. Mm-hmm. So thinking back, I think I played during Kunark, and I believe I stopped right after Luke Luckland. Because I played a wizard, and I have actually a really great original EverQuest story, because so it's kind of probably a lot of folks out there share a similar experience. I started and right, anyway, I had this wizard, right? And I got to like, I was 32, I think. I was one of the spell levels. And I just got there, and I was so excited because I think I'd gotten to the level where you could start quad kiting, right? And so or at least someone told me this. So I'm just like, I'm going to go do this. So I go and start doing it. And I failed terribly, and of course I die. And then I de-leveled and lost access to all these awesome new spells I just learned. And I then like immediately rage quit and didn't come back to the game for like a year. looking back, though, I'm just like, why did I do that? I don't understand. But anyway, when I came back to the game, and then shortly thereafter, they Luckland came out, of course, and being a wizard, it really irked me that they added the teleport room, and so that just seemed to, that really didn't rub me the right way, and so that's when I just pulled the ripcord, GTFO'd. Interestingly enough, though, about 5 years ago, I think, maybe four, EverQuest was on Steam, and it was, you could buy the whole thing for like $2. It was it was on special or something, like every X back, the whole thing, $2. I was like, what the hell? So I bought it and I started playing it. And I'm just like, this is not EverQuest. What did they do to this game? And then shortly, not too long after that, I stumbled, just kind of the same thing, stumbled on P99. And I don't even remember where I heard. I think I might have been just searching, like general Google search for like EverQuest. And I was like, what? Oh, it's because, see, I'd been involved with Ultima Online free shards. And so I think I explicitly was looking for an EverQuest free shard because I'm like, well, these guys probably do it better than live. And
as a matter of fact, we do it better than anybody else on the internet.
Exactly.
Sorry, that's a thing that I like to say.
No, it's great. I have a lot of respect for this server. I've enjoyed the hell out of it as a player, and I'm still enjoying it as a staff. I'm not entirely jaded, and I'm not jaded. I'm not entirely a bitter husk of a human being.
That's all right. We'll talk in April.
We'll talk. Yeah, give me a year.
And when your 1 year review comes around, we'll talk. We'll see. We'll go over all the different scars and wounds that you have. We'll look at the therapy that you've endured. We'll see.
Exactly.
It's, people don't know. You think it's all fun and games. It's, it just gets worse from here, buddy. It's not getting better. Micah.
What's up?
Correct me if I'm wrong on this, but you are in the Guild Anonymous, yes?
That is correct, Anonymous.
Good, good. Is that your only guild that you've been a part of? How long have you been with them?
Leveling up, you know, trying to do the stream thing. I was going to be gung-ho all the way to level 60, but once I hit about 50, I realized, you know what, I'm going to have to get some help. I made a post on the P99 forums, which if you guys aren't going to the forums, you really should. It's a great place to hang out.
www.project1999.com. You can go there. It has all the things you need to start playing on this wonderfully free server.
So I went to the server, the forums, and I made a post. Got a bunch of replies right away. Mm-hmm. I'm not sure if that was due to me streaming or just interacting with other players. But I tried out Azure Guard, and nothing against them. You know, great people. You know, I never had any issues with them. You know, all grouped with a bunch of them. It's just a timing thing issue. It just didn't work out. So as quietly as I joined the guild, I left. And I quickly went to Anonymous. And I'm loving it here.
Very nice. I saw you guys in Sky the other night, and I heard you saying on your stream that it was one of the first times you were doing something up there. And Tell me, how'd it go? What other stuff do you guys raid? Is that it right now? What are the plans? And time out. Also, if you have a guild website or a discussion thread, if they're interested in joining, tell them where they can go for that too.
I got one link. Hawkeye, the GM, he could probably post something else in your chat for the Anonymous Guild.
Do it, Hawkeye.
When I first joined, one of the first targets that I helped them take down was Queen, and that was apparently their first Queen downing. Apparently, nice. Anonymous has only been around for about 10 months. They were a splinter off of Knights Who Say Knee.
Oh, nice.
And so we're slowly starting to ramp up our numbers. We're right around about 100 active members right now, not counting alts. Alts, you know, it's a lot more. But about 100 active members. we've been doing plane clears. We're starting to get people keyed and starting to get ready to take over Saturday nights on Sky. We just recently got that.
And that was this Saturday? Was that the first time you guys were up there on the Saturday night slot?
First time I've gone with them. I think they've gone before.
Okay.
And I hadn't really progressed that far in the islands. I don't think I've ever done a full island clear. I recall doing Guan on my Monk back in the day. But, you know, that was 15 years ago.
right. So, like as you were saying, Saturday night, I guess it was, or maybe last week, whatever. Whatever Saturday that you were streaming that raid, you were mentioning about how, you know, you can only get 24 people keyed on a run. And so you got to get those people to renew their corpses and you got to key up more people and so on and so on. What do you guys, have you guys considered what the plan will be when the Sky corpses only last 24 hours?
Wow, that's news to me.
I wouldn't even be able to begin
to answer that.
Okay.
Maybe Fazul, who's in the chat right now, that's Hawkeye, the GM from our guild. He might be able to answer that.
I have a question for you. You probably might not be able to answer it, but I'm sure you could refer them to the guild site if that's where the info is. Level requirement for rogues or in general? Like, is there a general level requirement for the guild that you know of?
Yeah, it's 46 for everybody except wizards and clerics. That's 40
and up. Nice. You got to give them the special treatment. You need them.
Yeah, we need certain classes.
Everybody needs clerics. Get them in early, treat them good, make them loyal, raise them right.
See, that shows how good I am. I don't think any of my play characters meet those requirements. I'm an altaholic. I think I've got an alt on every. I think I have a character I actively play from time to time on every slot on my. I only have one play account.
But that is why you are so good for staff.
Exactly.
You don't have like you weren't in any of like the big guilds, so no one ever has to worry like, oh well, his friends are in Guild A and he probably hates people in Guild B, so he's not going to do things for them, and da-da-da-da.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, you got nothing.
I don't know. I think I may be in a guild, but it's a nobody guild. I think it's got like 3 guys in it or something.
Oh, man, I should disband your guild.
Do it now before the favoritism starts.
Oh, guilds. Is Anonymous working or raiding with any other guilds, or do you guys just pretty much do it yourselves?
I know we're on friendly terms with other guilds, but we're pretty much trying to go solo, I think.
Seeing what you can do on your own. I like that. I respect that. Well, I know I mentioned your Saturday night slot, whatever, too many S words. We talked about Sky's things. And I might have given the impression that there's a rotation on all things, but that's really only Sky. And the rest of raiding is broken into a class system. And for people that don't know, it's a competitive class, a restricted class, and then pretty much a free-for-all. And mobs rotate through those cycles. Some guilds are Class C, some guilds are Class R, and every guild can compete in the free-for-all. How is Class R living for you? Do you feel it's a fair system? Do you feel it's a good system? I guess not just Class R, but the whole system in general. As someone who's only been part of the server since February, it had been in place for a year already before you showed up. What's your thoughts on it? Good, bad, ugly? Give it to me. Give me the hard truth.
Well, coming back to the game, you know, I wanted to come back as a lot of people did with a different mindset. Back in the day when I was younger, before I had kids, different priorities, you know, raiding, that's all it was about.
Right.
It was very hardcore. Now coming back to it, I'm very leisurely about the game. I'm in Anonymous, they're raiding, I want to be a part of it, but I'm also focused on the streaming. But as far as the classes go, Class R seems like it was put in place for a reason. Whether or not it's being grown out of, or when, you know, Velius hits, you know, rumor is that you guys are just going to do away with the classes. That should be interesting. I think R really helps flesh out a guild and see where they stand compared to other guilds and see what they can accomplish. I can't comment on C.
Right. I won't ask you to name names, but just in a yes or no answer, do you think any of the guilds currently in Class R abuse being in Class R, or do you feel like all the guilds there do rightfully belong in that class?
I think abuse is a strong word.
What word would you use, Micah? Because I don't play. I haven't played since 2011. I'm so disconnected from like a player point of view. Like I have no opinion on it. I can't have an opinion because I'm, fuck man, 3 years, 3.5 years.
I'd say that, yeah, there's definitely guilds who could probably move up, but they don't want to put in, not necessarily don't want to put in that extra effort, but that extra effort to get to that next level would either be a strain on them or maybe they're just worried that they can't compete. I don't know. It's hard for me to really comment from my standpoint.
Right.
That's the way it seems. It seems like there's definitely guilds that probably could branch out.
Yeah. Well, so, oh man, I wish you had just a little inkling of what it was like before it existed. Because it was created for a reason. Like, there was literally the Class C guilds, those top two guilds, they had everything. It was basically how the free-for-alls are now, except there was no bag limit, and guilds could go do whatever they wanted.
I think I've got a little bit of inkling of what's been going on and stuff with the RNF forum.
RNF is... shit. Half the people who post that shit don't even play. It's a horrible representation. I think RNF makes both servers look bad, or at least worse than they are from a community point of view. I think P99's community in-game is really good, like really good. Many more good apples than bad apples. But on the forums, I feel it's the opposite. I feel you have many more shitty apples.
I think that's attributed to the anonymity of a forum.
I personally like to see our forum accounts locked to your player account. Like, you know, you're like, I don't know how we can do it technically, but like,
oh,
I think
we can do it. You should ask Rogan about it.
I thought I did. He's got
plans for that.
Oh, good.
That's what I'm talking about. Like, you have that anonymity of being able to be on the forums and not have it separated from your character in game.
Yeah.
But I think RNF is actually kind of a good thing, sort of. Not necessarily the way it's being represented now, but people need a place to vent. They have to have that. If you don't, it'll bleed into somewhere else.
Right. They need to learn not to cross lines into real-life attacks and other bad things. There shouldn't be pictures of people's families being posted. People shouldn't have their real-life things put out there. People take things too far sometimes, and I don't know if it's a lack of moderation, which I feel we've been cracking down on very well recently, or if it's other things, but I hate RNF so much. I hate it so much. I feel it just makes everybody look bad. But you are right. People do need a place to vent. I just feel it's used for more evil than good, I guess. But you still need it. You can't have it all over the rest of the forums. All right, Micah. And I guess, you know, I'll start with Brachnar. But Micah, know that I'm asking you this next. Brachnar, let's say there's people listening, and maybe they don't play here. Maybe they play on live. Maybe they don't play on anything, but they just found this stream, and they're like, holy shit, this is classic EverQuest. If they're on the fence, what would you say to them to kind of push them onto the go play this game right now side?
One thing it offers that a lot of games now don't is difficulty and consequences for your actions. For instance, the corpses, you know, your hand's not, or I guess better, more specifically, your hand is not being held. It's more of a, it's just a different experience, to be honest, and I find it. I find that a lot more fun than the current WoWs. I mean, if I actually went back and played, for those who are unaware, Nostralius, which is a World of Warcraft vanilla free shard, you know, player run shard, much the same as P99, and I was actually So I played WoW for years. I was shocked at how difficult WoW, vanilla WoW without mods was. It actually reminded me a lot of EverQuest, because you know there was no quest tracker, there was no quest markers on your minimap. You know, you actually had to read the quest text to determine what was going to happen and what you had to do. And I like that. So anyway, that's what drew me here, and that's what keeps me here, and that's what's kept me here all this time, is that it, and part of that is just the community feel. And another thing I particularly like about P99 and just this whole era is the fact that there are certain game mechanics that require you to interact with other players. And that's something that a lot of the modern MMOs have lost, because they try, you know, everyone says they want to be able to do it all themselves. Well, okay, so they let you do it all yourself, but then you don't ever have a need to contact, interact, or talk to another player. And so you're basically playing single player online games, which is just lame. So this really is a true multiplayer game where, you know, you need a port somewhere, you got to talk to somebody. You want to transfer items to another character, you got to talk to somebody. So that's why
you need a port from a wizard.
Exactly. Which is funny that I did roll a wizard here, but I haven't done much with it.
Oh, well, don't worry. If you ever level up your wizard here, nobody will ever be able to use wizard spires without you. None of that. We're just going to wait for the train to pick us up.
Yeah, exactly. Like, that was...
That's what it felt like. It felt like waiting for the goddamn L train. And you know the schedule, like, it's going to be here in 20 minutes, don't worry. Wherever we need to go. I don't remember, was there a Luckland thing for going to Hate or Sky? Was there ever a way to get there without wizards added?
Like I said, I only ever got to the mid-30s or 40s, I think, so I honestly don't remember. I definitely didn't get involved in the planes at all at that point.
Casual.
I know, I was a little casual.
It's okay.
Well, yeah, I didn't have a good, like, gaming mentality in those days. Like, I totally didn't pay attention to, like, anything around the game. Mm-hmm. Like, I opened up the client, I logged in, and I just did my thing, I talked to people, and that was that. Which is, it's funny, like, I am a completely different gamer now. Maybe it's because, you know, I'm older, and... You know, I got a kid to deal with and other things, but, you know, I don't know why, but it is so much, just what I want out of a game has changed so much, which I find it funny that there's that change, but here I am back where I was then. I'm just playing this game for different reasons. I think then I played it because my history, I began gaming with MUDs back when it was all text. And so the fact that I could have 3D graphics in front of me was already just amazing. And anyone familiar with MUDs, like, if you had your basic EverQuest chat window, that is what the MUDs looked like. You know, you see every round, and you see hit per round, and you see your chats all mixed in. Like, I don't even think on original EQ, I don't think you could split it out into different chat windows. And that never bothered me, because I was used to the MUDs. So, you kind of, like, read between the lines to see if somebody's sending you a tell or something like that.
Oh, MUDs.
Oh, no, yeah, I was totally hardcore into MUDs. I think I was a staffer on this MUD that I played when I was 16. I remember that. Good times.
I remember when EverQuest came out. I was so goddamn excited because it was like all that shit, but with graphics.
Exactly.
That takes me back to like 15, 16.
Mm-hmm.
It's like half a lifetime ago, literally. Micah.
Yeah.
Back to that original question, say people are on the fence about playing here, what would you tell them?
Well, I'd tell them to watch www.twitchtv.erf/MicahDavith. But no, I do get a lot of people in the stream, and I think, you know, I'm not trying to pat myself on the back, but I think there has been a large influx of streamers lately.
I can...
Both on Ragefire and P99. Go ahead.
No, you finish.
And so there's been a huge resurgence in interest, I think.
Mm-hmm.
And so I get new people who come in and they were like, oh, you know, just for grins, I typed in EverQuest in the search window on Twitch, and wow, I can't believe people are actually streaming this, and I can't believe people are actually playing it. And so they're like, man, should I install it? Man, I don't know if it's such a time sink. And I say, well, just hang out, watch. And some people come in and they're like, wow, I haven't seen Seb in years or whatever.
Seb is my favorite Kunark dungeon.
And so, you know, that nostalgia and coming back and playing the game is a huge draw for people.
Yeah. There are many players I've spoken to, new players, when I see legit new players in rags and such, I like to ask them how they found the server. And I can't even tell you how many times, back maybe a year or year, 2 years ago, not as much, but over the last 6 to 12 months, I can't even tell you how many people have told me, like, oh, I saw some guy playing on your server and he's streaming, and I couldn't believe it. It was classic EverQuest. And so, big thank you to everyone, or from everyone on the P99 staff, to you, Micah, and to the other P99 streamers, because you guys really do help get the word out that this server exists. You said yourself, you didn't even know about it till 2014-ish, and it's been around...
No, this year.
Or, sorry, 2015, damn. It's been around over 5 years. So yeah, I hate
myself.
There's a lot of people that really don't know about it, and a lot of our player base is like, oh, everyone who cares, they've already come and gone, or they're the people that are left, there's no new blood to bring in, and they're so wrong, because... so many people don't know it exists. And just big thank you from all of us to you and the other P99 streamers, because you guys really do help bring people to the server, and you give them a point of view and an insight that you can't get from reading a forum, and you can't get from looking at screenshots. You're actually seeing it as a player in the world, doing things, interacting with other players, wiping on a raid or succeeding in killing the boss on a raid, rolling on loots, like all of those things, all those little nostalgia things that you just simply can't get from reading the forums and seeing if that's going to pique your interest. Micah, when did you start? How long have you been streaming? What games did you stream? What do you stream the most now? Tell us about your stream.
So my stream, I've been doing it for about a year. I first started streaming Minecraft. That was, you know, a real, it still is a fun game. I still play it now, actually. I'll allude to that later. But, Minecraft, Battlefield 4, Counter-Strike, and then now EverQuest.
A+. Which of those games is your favorite?
It's a trick question.
EverQuest.
Well,
I will say, knowing that he only started in February and has a level 58, and I've been playing since 2013, and I think my highest level guy is 42, I really feel bad.
Yeah, we established you're a casual scrub.
I am a terrible casual scrub.
I'm a casual scrub.
Well, you're much more efficient of a casual scrub than Bracknar here.
I think it's probably because he stuck with one tune.
Maybe.
Yeah. That's actually part of the story, and I think that's part of the draw, is when I came back to the game, I wanted to try something different. And I mentioned I played a monk and a cleric. This time I wanted to play a warrior, and I figured if I'm going to come back and play this game, which is such a grind and such a pain in the ass, I'm going to play a half-elf warrior as my main character. No way to make money.
Yeah,
no way to make money. No way to twink this guy out. I mean, I got a little bit of help in the beginning,
but
I wanted to go completely hard mode.
Well, that's another thing I really like about this server, too, is, like, if you're a legitimate new player, 9 times out of 10, someone's going to spot you, and they're going to either give you a plat, or they're going to give you an item, or they're going to, you know, they're just going to help you out, which is really cool. I really appreciate that. I think I've created a couple of my alts, in fact, have had someone come and give me or try to give me stuff, and I'm like, no, I appreciate it, thank you, but I'm not a new player. Go give it to a new guy that really needs it.
Even back in the day when I was a player, I was like level 4, and some nice wood elf was like, take these things, and traded me a few items to start with, and one was a flowing black robe, and I was so excited, and that's when I was like, I'm just gonna keep playing this character, because I'm awesome now. Like, it's, again, I love our community. Most of them are nice. Most of them will give people things and help them out. Being a streamer, I'm sure that definitely helped with people offering you things to help you out. Just because, you know, more people are aware that you're starting out as a new player. Yeah, those are things. I want to know more about your stream, though. Do you have any kind of like set schedule? Why should people follow your stream? What do you offer besides that sweet, soothing voice that other people do not have? What are you bringing to the table?
Well, besides the audible chocolate, my schedule, I mean, I work a full-time job. I don't stream full-time. That's not my focus. It's not what I'm aiming for.
Right.
I Twitch because I have fun I have fun and I enjoy interacting with my viewers and my friends. You know, I consider most of them friends. Music is probably one of the biggest things in the channel. People can come in, request songs, and you can be a troll and you can pick a trolley song. Everybody's going to hate you and they'll skip your song. I don't control that. I give that all to the viewers. They're the ones deciding to and what we're doing. And I think it's just the interaction, really.
Interaction's big. I've been very horrible with chat interaction so far this evening. And I'm actually really sorry about that. I'm actually going to scroll through chat real quick. And we'll give a shout out to the coach. And Rogan Java Mug. Yes, he's knocking 50% of my paycheck off. Does Rogan ever scream at people in TeamSpeak or Skype? I'm pretty sure Rogan has screamed at me, but he's got too much class to spit while he screams, and you can't really get spit on over Skype. Wish this Bracknar dude would pour himself? I don't know what that even means. What does that mean?
Ultima Online reference. That was one of the most common spells cast. So in Ultima Online, when you would cast a spell, everybody else would see these like special spell words, and one of them was Corpor, which was energy bolt. It was kind of like the main direct damage spell, and so yeah, that's a reference to UO.
All right.
Whoever that was, nice.
That was Little Gyno.
Oh.
Lakos wants more Micah. Micah, people love you, but Java Mug does not love you because apparently you're not relaying important messages. Same questions over and over again. Jankbot says increase lockouts. I don't know how increase, unless you mean allow. I think he means allow people to kill more things, but I think that will just piss off everyone in Class R. Someone threatening to mace me. Doot, 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 doot. Make all RNF posters. Like, Essage. I could be wrong, so I probably shouldn't say anything. But let's just say that in a perfect-ish world, you will absolutely live in a place where form accounts are connected to in-game accounts. That's something everybody thinks is a good idea. Do do do, love how Sirkin just creeps on people. Yes, that's a thing. Do 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 do, been playing 100 days here, level 34. You keep grinding ripe tomatoes. That's the other thing I'm gonna rant on for a minute. One thing that EverQuest has that other games don't have is it's a grind. Like, you're not gonna get to max level quickly, and you're supposed to enjoy the thing. It's not one of those games. I don't like games where it's like, okay, well, I just got to grind to max level and then I can start playing. Like, EverQuest, the whole thing was the game. There was quests, there was interaction with other people, there was a very long, tedious level process that made you really, really appreciate every time you heard that sound. And you knew, like, oh, god damn it, thank you, level 36. I don't ever have to deal with level 35 XP again, ever, ever, ever. And then you get to the next one, I believe was 45? Oh, hell levels. Hell levels were horrible. But,
I was going to say, like, that's one other thing you're kind of touching on that I really, really liked. Like, I can't stand any of these modern games where, like, literally people are top level in 2 weeks, and you're just like, I mean, that completely belittles having a top level. Like, who cares? Oh, you have one top level? Oh, great. You know, whereas in EverQuest, if you got a 60, or someone's like, damn, that guy put in some time. You know?
Yeah. And we can tell just how much time you have by how many 60s you have. That's the thing, though. It's not easy. Every time you got a new level, like, you really were happy as shit about that.
Are you kidding? I was happy when I got one extra AC or one extra piece of strength.
That's the other thing. The numbers are not all jacked up just to make people feel good about themselves. You get a +5 hit point item, and you're like, this is the best thing ever. I got those +2 silver intelligence rings on my mage on live, and I thought I was fucking unstoppable. I was like, oh yeah, bitches, I got +4 intelligence total. I was very excited about those rings. And even, I didn't feel like those items were less valuable because I was a lower level. Like, I was stuck in those levels for so long that each piece of gear mattered, and it stuck with me for a long time. It's not like, okay, well, I'll use this gear today, but it won't matter because in 5 levels, the gear is going to be so much better that this is all garbage. Like, your gear mattered, and your levels mattered, and every little tiny scrap of stuff that you got, like, it really mattered. And I don't get that feeling in new games. It's just, all right, everyone, race to the max level, and let's see what happens. And then you find out there is no end game, and games die. That's the other thing. If you're going to make a game, and you're going to make it just ass easy to get to the end level, why wouldn't you make good end game content? Why would you release games with little to no or just bad end game content? At least make the leveling process a horribly long, grindy experience, because that will buy you time to add or tweak or do whatever you have to do to the end game before people get there. It's retarded when you can level to the end of the max level in 2 weeks and be like, well, we're max level, we did all the raids, you only had one, it was stupid, now what do we do forever? And then games fucking lose players, and then games go free to play, and then games lose support, and then games die. And then a bunch of nerds emulate it on the internet. Oh, Jesus.
Micah, is that another OT hammer? I think that's another OT hammer.
No, it's not. No, it's not. I put the OT hammer away.
Okay, I didn't actually check you, but I just saw it. I was like, that looks like an OT hammer. So you know, Sirkin, I may have a Kazakhthul illusion on myself in Freeport.
You may have. Well, you know what? I feel like that's classic, so that's okay.
It is. That's it actually okay. It looks really cool with that sword.
Do not turn yourself into a frog lock, though.
Apparently, yeah.
That's not badness. Classic.
It is not. Especially frog bombing the EC tunnel. That's just not cool, man.
No, I don't do that.
Who does that? Nobody does that.
Nobody does that. Nobody. That's not a thing that happens, because that shit ain't classic. It definitely also doesn't happen in Karnor's Castle or Sebelius. I'll tell you that. Those are definitely not things that are happening. And hopefully if anyone thinks they saw something like that, they'll go contact their doctor right away and not do something stupid like make a petition based on fabricated nonsense, hallucinations. Because that's what it is. Because no one on this staff would do anything like that. Mm-mm-mm. So, Micah, we touched on all the things that got you started here, and what you're doing here, and how you found it, and your guild. What keeps you logging in every day since February?
Honestly, it's been my viewers. I mean, I play other games still. I still, you know, I usually wrap up the night playing H1Z1, which is a zombie survival game. Mm-hmm. And just recently, for the past like week or so, Magnate, my buddy, my cohort, he has turned on his Minecraft server. So we're trying to get, you know, people who are interested in Minecraft, you know, when they want some downtime away from EverQuest, you know. It's there. If some people are interested, there's limited space. You have to apply, but
where do they apply? Tell us about this server.
They just gotta find Magnate in my stream and send him a message and through Twitch. It's a private whitelisted server. Nobody can join it unless he adds you. So we're just trying to keep it for the Project 99 players. You know, people who like Minecraft and who like playing EverQuest. We're planning on doing like racial statues. For the different races in EverQuest.
That's really cool. How many people do you guys have working on that right now?
Well, like I said, we just started the server about a week ago, a little over a week ago, and it's right around 15 people, but he's bumped up the server capacity to about 40.
Okay. All right. So you guys are taking applications. And they just go find Magnate in your stream.
And yeah, he's pretty much there all the time.
Magnate.
Magnate AZ.
There you go. Find that person. If you guys have interest in Minecraft, I personally never played Minecraft, but I kind of play a game that's like Minecraft, but with guns. And
so well, I don't know. Earlier today, you seemed to be on the fence.
I did kind of flip the table earlier today, didn't I? Bracken, I have to put you in charge for a second. I got to do something.
Oh, boy. So, since I'm here, I guess everybody may recall, or folks that are listening to the stream, the last time I was on, I was ranting and raving about boxers. And we're still, unfortunately, I think every day I'm still suspending 1 to 3 accounts, pairs of accounts that get caught for boxing. And one thing I wanted to let everybody know, tell your friends, tell your guilds, tell your guildmates, tell your cat, tell your dog. Because if you look at the calendar, we're a little more than 30 days away from the Velius launch. Now, if you get caught for boxing, that's a 30-day suspension. So if you happen to be boxing anytime between now and, say, Velius, actually probably like next week and say Velius, then you're going to miss Velius if you get caught. Don't do it. I've caught people that were literally on for 2 seconds to transfer items, because you know what? You transfer items, it goes in the logs, and we can see it. So don't do it. Anyway, that's my little spiel for two boxing. We hate suspending people. I don't like doing it, but that's the rules. And if we catch you, we're going to get you.
I like doing it.
Circuit likes doing it.
Came back at the right time.
Perfect.
I have a buddy who came in from San Diego, and him and another one of my buddies came over surprisingly unannounced. And I was like, let's hang out. And we were out in the yard talking. And then I was like, hey guys, I have to abandon you because I do a stream on Monday nights for an elf simulator. And so that was an interesting conversation. And then I did straight up abandon them in my yard with my brother and came here to be with all of you wonderful people. And they were just letting me know that they were leaving. So I had to, you know, give them hugs and tell them I love them and send them on their merry way. So clearly, better GM than friend is what we're learning tonight.
That's your priorities, right?
Mm-hmm.
Please, port to Dreadlands, please.
Me?
Port. Oh, you're asking for me to port you to Dreadlands?
No. Sorry. Oh, okay. Can you guys hear that? I thought I was on push to talk.
Sorry.
Nope. Skype is...
I was calling my buddy. He was AFK from the computer.
Yeah. Skype's just open mic, but you can set like a push to mute button. And a lot of people, what they'll do is they'll make their... Like if you're in TeamSpeak, they'll make their push to talk in TeamSpeak their push to mute in Skype. And that way, when you push to talk in TeamSpeak, it actually mutes you from Skype. I have no idea how to do that, though, because I don't bother. But somebody actually complained that I was eating Gushers on my stream last week. I just wanted you guys to know I'm eating them again right now.
Did you say they were Gushers? Or did, mm-hmm. I mean, okay. I don't remember you saying that. That's why I was like, did they just know they were Gushers by the sound? Because that's pretty impressive.
No, I told them I had a delicious package of Gushers, and they were going to have to deal with me chomping away. And they were like, that is the worst fucking thing ever. Don't do it again. And so I opened a pack of Gushers, and I spelled out the word hi, and I took a picture and uploaded it to the forums. Because I felt that was an appropriate response. Look, guys, I buy fruit snacks. I can't help that. They're a big part of my life. They make me who I am. Bracknar.
Yo.
What about for you? What's the draw of P99?
Now just being doing the stab gig. Actually, another good draw, I guess. Here's another good example. Like last week or maybe the week before, it was a great experience that just I'm sure everyone's had, where you're in doing your thing in a zone, whatever. You're killing mobs, you're grinding mobs or something, and you just randomly meet some dude, and then you start talking, and you're like, oh, hey, let's start doing these mobs, and you start doing, And next thing you're raking in XP hand over fist, and it's just things are going really well. And then let's get everybody on friends list. And then next thing you know, you're grouping with a guy every other night. It's just one of those cool situations where, you know, that sort of thing just still, I've said it before, it just doesn't happen in any of the modern MMOs. You don't typically run into some dude and then group with him often. It's a lot of, you know, the first, single player online games.
Yeah.
So that's actually, since I became staff, I hadn't really played much until about a month ago. And then I was just sitting here, I was like, what the hell? So I made a little druid because I'd never had a druid. So I just made this little druid and I'm putzing him around. So you never know, if you group with a druid out there, you might be grouping with me. although I will admit, humorously enough, on my player, I've grouped a couple times, or at least been not necessarily grouped, rather. I've just been running around and I look and I'm like, those two people look like boxers. And you know what? The past three times I've thought that, they were indeed, and they were suspended. So they're out there.
Well, we know they're out there. We catch them all the time.
Yeah.
I'm looking for something that I saw a second ago, and I just can't find it. Gimpy99. I have nothing to do with server repops. I don't even know ahead of time when they're happening. I don't know afterwards. I only know about repops essentially if I happen to be like chatting in Skype with Rogan, or if I'm in game and I see the world shake and feel like my computer's breaking. That's how I know about repops. I find out most times a player will send me a message and be like, you need to log in, there's a repop, help. And that's how I know they're even a thing.
Oh, okay. I your play see it too, sir, because he tagged you. So, Karen Derry?
Hold on.
Oh, okay.
One other thing before, because that's right after this.
Oh, yeah.
Gunaku, I'm just going to tell you. Gunaku says you should keep eyes on the Zolgaz spawn in Kaesora, because there's many boxers there. And if you want to hit on Kara Dry or whatever his name is, his thing, go ahead.
Yeah, so just, I guess for everyone here, it says, why are you banning people who are having issues with characters still logged in, and they still log in their accounts during that time? Not being in the game, but the IPA is locked and they have proof. It wasn't me, but I'm having numerous accounts. Okay, so I have had, someone has given me that excuse once or twice. There's been one or two pairs. I can't recall which. But it wasn't that. The person claimed, let me go back. There's been a few people that have claimed something along this line. One in particular fairly recently who claimed he pulls up a client, it goes black screen, and he opens the second client. Well, there, that's the problem, because how do I put this? Like, when I've played...
Time out. Are they trying to log in a character from the same account?
No. So they open up client one, log into account one, it locks up. And so then they can't see that, and then they either minimize or forget that, supposedly, they forget that's there, then they open up client two, log in account two. One of those accounts will have an exemption, and so they show up, and it looks like they're two-boxing. Mm. And so part of that's really difficult to nail down, right? Because
but
I had...
You can't you see what they're doing? Like, if they're actually in the world or not in the world?
They are in the world. But that's kind of what these that's kind of where I'm saying that his information is not entirely correct, because the two characters are indeed in the world here. It's just that the person is claiming, oh, I opened up client one and it crashed, so I opened up client two, and I didn't know I was still connected from client one. But that kind of what I was getting at is, like, whenever if I'm playing EverQuest and I have a client that crashes,
mm-hmm.
I end task it. I don't just minimize it and open up another client. So, you know, it is dealt with case by case. There was a case fairly recently where someone had logged in a character that was in, I forget, it was in a, they were in a dun, they had been logged out in a dungeon. And then they had logged in character one, and then 3 minutes later, they logged in character two from a different account, and they were both on at the same time. That particular case, personally, I ruled that that was likely boxing because the guy was maybe watching for spawns on one and then moved to the other one.
Yeah.
If that's incorrect, I mean, you're always free to come to the forums. You're free to ask for Sirkin to come and step in. Then he comes in, he can look at more things. But, you know, we can only look at so much to see if something happened. The reason I moved on that one is because the login times were so close. You know, if you're gonna box, you're most likely going to pull both accounts up pretty close together. But I could also see this the converse. But then again, if what he claimed was actually true, there's no, I don't know. I just didn't feel that it was likely in the at that time. And a lot of us just have to make a judgment call. Sometimes we're right, sometimes we're wrong. But that's why Sirkin's here, because if you think we're wrong, you can go to the forums and you can post that I think the staff was wrong, and Sirkin will take a look at it. So yeah, I think that's what you're getting at, Karendry. I'm sorry if I'm butchering the name. He just put something else. I'm all for banning suspending boxers, but people who don't even have IP exemptions and trying to legitimately just play on a single tune. I guess I don't know what he's talking about there. Any rate, so I guess we'll leave it at that. But, you know, generally with boxers, we do a pretty decent investigation. We can see a good amount of things. We can see if someone's active, if someone's inactive. You know, we can see if they've got a guy on EC and he's making trades. You know, we see he's doing stuff. Like, for instance, I guess kind of referencing another issue where we had one issue where some guy has had supposedly left his character logged in all night. And we were able to verify. And again, since the login times, everything coincided with his story, we didn't move on it. So again, like I said, if Karen, if you know this fella and you think I made a mistake, I'm human, it was a judgment call, tell him to post and Sirkin will look at it.
I feel like he's saying that somebody is logging in. Someone logs in an account. Let's say they log in John Doe off account one. And that they're trying to log in another character from account one and it won't let them, or it will let them and they're getting banned for it. But here's the thing. Unless you're not going to get suspended unless you have two characters in the world. If you do something like, oh, I left my character at character select and just forgot, we know that that's what you're doing. If you just make that up, we know that you're lying. We can see. And so we won't necessarily suspend you, but we will tell you and probably take away your IP exemption. But we will tell you that that's not why your IP exemption exists. It does not exist so that you can have, two clients open and just switch back and forth quickly from one tune to the other. The only reason anyone gets an IP exemption is so that multiple players can play from the same household or the same IP address more correctly. And if you're using it for any other purpose, you're abusing your IP exemption. And that means that you can abuse your exemption in more ways than just two boxing. Having a character at character, having two clients on your goddamn machine so you can switch back and forth, you know, even if you keep one logged out, you're still abusing the exemption because you now have an advantage that other players don't have. And so you can absolutely lose your exemption for that. And don't do it. Somebody asked if you could play on blue and red at the same time. Yes, they're different servers. And so that's not two boxing. Just one character per server per person at a time.
And I see someone says many boxers in K Sora. If you see him, report him. And I think, like, people actually heard that message from a few weeks ago, because I know I've seen a hell of a lot more player reports. And, you know, obviously we're not going to tell you specifics, but some do indeed result in suspensions. In fact, actually, no, that one wasn't a player report. I recently had one where it was some guy running three tunes at once, no exemptions across the board, but ended up two of those three tunes, he'd already been busted for boxing. And so that gentleman with two nearly level 60 tunes now has two permabans, because that's how things work. If you get caught once, you get 30 days. If you caught twice, you're gone for good.
Yeah, two strikes and you're out.
Pretty much.
That's fuck baseball.
Well, it's unfortunate. It was the same. I'm not going to tell you who it was, but it was the same. He was caught boxing with the same two characters once already, and he was caught again with the same two characters. But then he'd added a third. And it's just like, you know, dude doesn't learn.
did you mention, remind people that Velius is coming?
Yes, I did. That when you first stepped away, yep, I reminded Velius is coming. You know, if you're going to box at all, this is probably the dumbest time to do it over this next, like, 2 to 3 week period.
Yeah, don't cheat. Don't cheat between now and Velius, dummies. I mean, why? Yeah, yeah. Why would you throw it all away?
Before we pushed that date out, people I'd suspended, you know, shortly before the original Velius launch, like, oh my God, the tears. And it sucks for them, and it kind of sucks for us to have to do it. But yeah, you know, that's just how it is.
I don't know. So many people have been waiting so long for Velius, and I know there's a lot of new people coming over, and a lot of them are used to being able to get away with cheating on live servers and such. This isn't EQ Live. Like, we don't give any shits about the amount of people that play here because it's free. We don't see dollar values. We don't have to worry about, oh, well, we're going to lose our job if we don't make enough money. Like, that's a luxury we have that real, actual companies and businesses don't have. I forgot where I was going with that already. But just don't cheat, because we will absolutely ban your account. Like,
yeah.
We don't need people here that aren't going to play by the rules. We want as many players as possible, as long as they'll follow the rules and not cheat. But we absolutely don't want you here if you're going to cheat. And just because you're able to cheat on other games and other servers, you're not going to be able to cheat here. We have stuff in place that will take care of you if you try running third-party programs. We have very good, vigilant staff members like Bracknar here who will bust you for two-boxing. We've got the people. We've got top men working on it.
Top men.
That's what we got. Oh, so yeah. Just play legit. Don't do the real money transaction shit. The two-boxing shit. Don't do the third-party stuff. I mean, it's really pretty simple.
Well, that's the thing, too. RMD, it's like, it's all logged, people. You know, you think you're getting away with a drop trade? It's all still logged.
You're not going to get away with it. It doesn't matter how many times you transfer it around or move it around or try to be sneaky. Delete characters. None of that shit matters.
It's absurd how easy it is to still track that stuff down.
Yes. You know. Yes.
I obviously without giving details, but just so people know, it is still very, very easy to track that down. You're buying yourself like a fraction of a second for each time.
Once upon a time, we had to go to Rogan to look that up. But thanks to Rogan Magic, we can all look it up on our own at any goddamn moment we feel like. And so just don't do dumb things. I mean, we have rules in place. We take them seriously, contrary to what you might read on our forums or other forums about P99. We do take the rules seriously. We don't just let people break the rules. If anyone has any proof of anyone breaking rules, they should petition it. And they should include any proof they have. Don't just petition and be like, you need to ban this guy because he's doing this, and I don't have any proof, but I know it's a thing. We can't ban someone for that. But submit proof. And if you're going to submit like a 30-minute Fraps video and be like, there's a train in this, just watch the whole thing, I'm not going to. Put a timestamp, direct my attention to something. And I guarantee you, if you submit things that are showing people breaking rules, be it speed hacking. I had a streamer catch someone speed hacking through Sebelius on their stream, and they chopped it into a little highlight and sent it into the petition form. And sure enough, that person got banned, and it sucks sometimes that we can't share like what disciplinary action we take against the person with the person who petitioned it, because I'm sure they would like to know that something happened, but we're just not allowed to. And so you'll get a response like, I'll check into that, thank you, and you'll be like, well, that's it, you're not going to tell me like how it plays out, you're not going to tell me if you're doing anything, what's going on? You should know that we do check into that. And if absolutely nothing happened, that means you probably didn't have anything to support your claim. But if I mean, put the player on your friends list. See if they log in for the next 7 or 14 or 28 days, depending on how long or how many times they've been suspended. And I know there's pros and cons for not making that information public, but it's just staff policy that we don't make it public right now. And so that's a thing. Micah, you ever catch anyone breaking any, like, speed hacking or hacking it up on stream?
No, but I have been accused of two-boxing here on the server because of my friend Magnate. His name is, yep, AFK, his surname. And he seems like he's AFK sometimes. I don't think so.
Okay.
I don't think so.
See, that's the thing. A lot of time, you know, even though someone says two-box, you know, oh, so-and-so's two-boxing, a lot of times we're going to come and watch, like I think I said before, on the last time I was talking about boxing, by the time you see, like, me or another staff member that's come visible to test you, we're already 90% sure you're boxing. Because we've probably been sitting there for 10 to 15 minutes watching you move, and we can tell what's going on. It's not that hard to see, you know, character one turns, character two turns. The biggest the best part, I wish there was a way, like, I could force mobs to switch targets, because that's the best time to tell. Like, if you have a cleric and a warrior, right, and then the mob all of a sudden starts hitting the cleric, and the cleric doesn't back up, move, or, you know, do something to prevent it, it's pretty obvious, you know. But not always. Again, it's case by case.
I seen a bunch of people boxing in the hole one time, and I was watching them for a good 10 or 15 minutes, and it was three people, and they were each two boxing. And because at first I'm like, is this one guy six boxing? And I'm like, no, too many people are doing too many things. And then I asked Rogan to check something for me, and he was able to confirm that it was three people, and they were each two boxing. And so one other thing I did, I guess just for my own giggles, was I spawned, they were fighting those earth elementals, and so I just spawned a couple extra ones and stuck them on the tunes that I knew were tabbed out, just to kind of see the reaction time of those tabbed out players. And they didn't even bother tabbing back. They just would use the characters they were on to beat things and get the aggro on them. And then I just DT'd them all and suspended them appropriately.
DT is a GM only thing, right? I actually never have tried, but I don't.
You should
don't
have a book. You should have an item that you can right click for DT.
Really?
Yeah, if you don't have that, I should get you that.
Yeah, I'll look for it.
But, you know, don't use it willy-nilly. Use it where it's deserved. Usually I like to do it right before I suspend somebody.
Oh, man, if I knew I could do that, that would make suspending people kind of fun, then.
Yeah, because then they have to petition for their corpse after they're suspended.
Nice.
Yeah, because it's just one more little, like, oh, follow the goddamn rules. like, you know, I need help getting my corpse back because it rotted because I got suspended for being an asshole. It's like, well, then good. Good. Don't be an asshole, and you won't have to deal with the repercussions of assholiness. That's my feelings on it. Oh, man. There were some things that I was planning on saying this evening as I look at my list, and now I'm realizing I probably shouldn't.
Now I'm going to go look at your list and see what it is, see if I can figure out.
There's
what
one
about
sentence in the middle that's in quotation marks, and it's a quote that somebody else used that I was just absolutely going to tear apart, and now I'm thinking it's one of those things that Rogan might get mad at me about doing. And so I'm thinking I'm just going to skip right over that and the one underneath it.
Oh, I got a question for Micah. Have you had any, I've dealt with some people that have done this, have you had any folks messing with you while you're streaming, training you, that sort of thing?
I used to hang out with a bunch of other streamers, like when I was in the early 20s, early 30s levels, and like Darth Craze and some other ones. And I heard that they were getting trained in Miss Moore and things like that, and supposedly something was implemented to fix it. I personally have never had that happen to me.
Oh, something was definitely implemented to fix it. If you want to see what it is, go make a level one and try to zone into like Lava Storm or like pretty much any non-lobby zone. We put minimum levels on most non-starting zones of 5 to prevent that exact thing. It was that bad. It really had gotten out of control.
I like it. Bostonio wants to know do you ever had people that legit transfer large amounts of coin and believe it's RMT? We have had people, I know personally, I've had people make large transfers, and what I'll do is I will pull the character's trade history and I will shoot over to the character pretty instantly to see what he's doing and who he's doing it with. And then I just kind of take it from there and see what it looks like. I've seen so many RMT accounts at this point that they pretty much have a pattern. And when you recognize that pattern, it's really easy to spot a legit character or even a legit EC tunnel trader as opposed to an RMTer. So I wouldn't worry about that. Yes, it gets our attention. Yes, we shoot over. Very rarely do we appear, though. Like, if we go, two-boxing, for example, there's tons of times where, I'm sure Bracknar, too, where a staff member goes, checks on two-boxers, watches for 15 minutes or so, and decides these people aren't boxing, and just leaves, and never appears, and the players never even know a staff member was there. So, yeah, you just got two answers for one question. Look at you. Da, 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 da. That's a bold assumption, Conscript X says. I play a caster, and when a melee starts attacking me, I don't move because then it just causes the tank to have to chase me around. I just sit there and take the D and hope they pull it off.
So, yeah, I guess a little more clear. That's kind of why I said it just case by case. It's not necessarily that. It's more how the caster reacts. Here's another example that I was noticing earlier today. I've played a number of healers, right? And when you're healing, I understand a lot of times, sometimes you're not going to turn your character. But whenever we have a character that's facing one direction that's a healer, and say it looks like we're two-boxing a warrior cleric, and the cleric rarely ever turns their character. All they do is stand, heal button, sit. Stand, heal button, sit. Mm-hmm. That kind of thing. And then add on to that the fact that if they get mobs or something along those lines and they don't really react, it kind of boils down to what Sirkin mentioned with reaction time. It, like when he was spawning the mobs, just see what they do. So it all factors together. So it's not a situation of if I see a cleric and they're only and they don't move when they're attacked, I'm instantly going to suspend you for 2 bucks. And that's right. Not the case.
It's not just one thing. It's never just one thing. We actually hold our staff members accountable, and if a player appeals a suspension and says they were wrongfully suspended, a different staff member will absolutely look into that. If it's one of the guides, I'll look into it. If it's about me, Rogan or Nilbog will look into it. If you have a problem with Nilbog, you should just get out.
Just leave
now. Because no one's going to do anything, but you're also tinfoiling, because Nilbog is probably one of the greatest people I know, and especially when you compare him to internet people. And I'm not, you know, I love you internet people, don't take this the wrong way. All of you here tonight, you're not part of that. I'm talking about all the other internet people that aren't here tonight. They're the bad ones. Yawkers wants to know, can't you just check MAC address since it would be the same, they have different IP and PC, blah, 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 blah. Here's the thing. There's a lot of things we can check. There's, I'm sure, a lot of things we can't check, but we can't really discuss or talk about what we can or cannot check. We don't want to make it easier for two boxers. Just like we're not going to talk about how we catch RMTers because we don't want them to know all the things we can do and see. We want them to get caught. Oh, and PSA, please don't RMT. I think I said this earlier. But please don't do it. We don't want you to do it. And don't accuse us of RMT. We wouldn't tell you not to do it if we were involved in it. Use your brains. Bracknar, do you have anything else about RMT or two boxing or banning or anything else in that realm of stuff.
No, we probably should close the book on that. I didn't really want to get too into it tonight. I did want to mention that, you know, like we did the Velia stuff, but no, you know, like you said, see something, say something. Doesn't hurt to report on. And I'll say the best way to report is if you put in a petition on the forums. That's probably the better way. In-game petitions are not as good, because just, you know, we have gaps in our coverage, so sometimes people don't see it. But yeah, the best place for any sort of, you know, I don't use the word like tattletaling, but no, just like anytime you see something that somebody is breaking a rule, if you see any rule breaking, the best place to put it is the forums.
Look, it's not like snitching on your friend.
It's not.
It's like seeing a suspicious man put down a suitcase at the airport and then walk away. That's all it is. You just, hey, I don't know if this guy is dirty or legit, but maybe someone should look at that suitcase. That's all you're doing. You're just pointing us in the direction of the suitcase. And exactly. It helps lots of people. Arta 33. Oh, Micah. Do you have any thoughts on two box or on like two boxing, third party programs, RMT?
Yeah, definitely two boxing. You know, that's definitely a no-no here. I used to legit two box back in the day, you know, 99 to 2004. I had two accounts, I had two internet connections, two computers, paid for both subscriptions. So I was a legit two boxer back in the day. Now, with there's such a focus on community and what this game should really be about, I don't understand why people would want a two box.
Yeah. See, it's different if it's allowed. I mean, if it's allowed and everyone's doing it, that's a different story. I played on an emulator before P99 was a thing, and it allowed up to two, but you could two box. That was the limit. And I was fine with that because that was the rule. I personally didn't really do it because I can barely control one character, and two just was a mess. But we just don't like it here. We feel, as far as community goes, or rather as far as community building goes, allowing people to box only hurts that. And we feel that community is probably the most important part of EverQuest. It's definitely not these stellar graphics, tell you that. So, but let's move on to more general things. Something I wanted to talk about, instance zones. Actually, I have a question. Do you or have you played on either of the new timeline progression servers, Micah?
No, I haven't, because I don't believe that the live or the progression servers are what EverQuest was meant to be. I know there's a lot of players, and I have a lot of people who hang on my stream that do play on it, but they prefer to watch, you know, me or my streamer hang out and listen to the music. I'm not going to hate on them. You know, different games are popular to people for different reasons. It takes a special person, a special kind of breed of gamer to want to torture yourself and play EverQuest, you know, the way it was meant to be played.
Yeah, I hear that. Well then, maybe you don't play, but maybe you know, because I don't know. Do you know if they have instant zones? And regardless, how do you feel about instant zones? We don't have them here on P99, but a lot of newer MMOs do have instance raids and instance things and different shards of the same place. How do you feel about those type things in your games?
Well, I think that would just detract from a community and like an MMO feel. It just it isolates people from other people having instances like that.
What would you say to the counter argument of, if we don't have instances, one guild will just monopolize everything and we'll never get to see content?
Well, I guess that's why guilds should work together, you know, different schedules, you know, kind of like I have Class R and Class C now. You know, they have to come to an agreement.
For the record, I agree with you. I'm just playing devil's advocate. I think instant zones are the devil. And exactly as you said, I think they are kind of like a roadblock for community building. I mean, surely it's like, well, we can all group up and our group can join the same shard and you'll still be able to play with your friends. And that's cool if you have friends to start with. But if you just want to meet people, I mean, there's groups. I remember I spent a good 10 levels leveling with the same group of people in Kedge Keep on live. And I might never have found those people if there were different instances of Kedge Keep or different shards of Kedge Keep. And I feel it really detracts from community building. I get the whole lag thing. I get the whole guilds are monopolizing everything. It's the devil. I get all of that. I think instant zones do more harm than they do good. And I think a lot of game makers are so, what's the word? Not worried, but so, they care too much about what the loud crybaby people are going to say on the forums about, oh, this guild's monopolizing things, and oh, there's too many people, everything's camped. I think game makers need to stop listening to players, and I think they just need to make a game the way they want to make it. And if you want instant zones, then make instant zones. But don't not have instant zones because you're worried people are going to cry about it. I hate instant zones. How do you feel about instant zones, Bracknar?
I'm kind of there with Micah. You know, I do feel it does take away a bit from the... it does detract a bit, from the feel of the game. But sorry, I'm actually talking to Possible Boxer, so I have my attention is lacked.
That's fine. You deal with your boxers. I'm going to go to the chat box. Arta33 wants to know if an item says pending lore and it will be activated with Velius, would there be any kind of documentation before then to let people know so they could prepare? Here's what I'm going to say. If an item says pending lore, there is a chance that it will be changed or updated with the launch of Velius. So you should just prepare for that. If you know it happens later in the timeline, then you should expect it to happen later in the timeline. If you're referring to the blue diamond jewelry, I'm pretty sure that was in with the Velius launch. Don't quote me on that in case I'm wrong. But if that's the case, then those should be updated when Velius launches. And if that's not the case, they'll be updated whenever they were added to the game appropriate for the timeline. Caradry, I'm sorry we're butchering your name tonight, sir. He's got a question regarding raid suspensions. Can we get less gray areas as to what is allowed and not allowed during these suspensions? Particular example, is Sky considered a part of the lockout? And can we have more attentive responses on lockouts for these questions? Possibly in form of just asking in the suspension thread. Would be sweet to be able to ask questions during these times. Sky has never been part of a raid suspension. As far as I'm aware, raid suspended guilds could still do Sky. And that's mostly because the staff has decided to respect the Sky rotation that the guilds have formed on their own and kind of uphold on their own. We don't want to suspend someone for a week and then another guild's like, well, we're taking your Sky spot. And then the whole rotation just falls to shit because guilds stop honoring it. And so that's pretty much why Sky's never been a part of a raid suspension. I'm pretty sure everything else, like every other raid target, is indeed considered a raid suspension. So I hope that answers your question. Conscript X. Don't worry about that. I watched them for a while. Ripe Tomatoes, something about putting on Oasis. I don't know what you mean, good sir. Alaris says, what do I have to do to get Rogan to bring up the beta server? I don't want to harass him playing CSGO. Alaris, there is nothing you can do to make Rogan do things. He does things in his own time. Yucker says, My guild used to make me 3 bucks, warrior, monk, cleric, because they hated me and wanted me to die early. Shit was rough to raid playing 3 tunes. I bet, Yuckers. I bet. I would never play 3 tunes. I didn't even like alts because my thought process was I should be bettering my main character at all times. I should, any time or gear I put into an alt is time and gear that's not going into my main. And so I was always a one character kind of person. I demand 10 instances of Seb. Alaris, I demand that you GTFO. Conscript says, I'm playing on a TLP server right now. Ragefire. Instances don't stop people from camping the loot spawns. It just gives them more chances to get the spawn. Kick Oh, kill, pick, kill, pick, kill, pick. Meh. Well, that's something I never even thought of. I guess you could do that. You could just jump from one shard to the next. But I imagine the better camps would already be camped on the other shards, unless you just went there and stole a camp from somebody, which I imagine happens a lot on modern day MMOs, mostly because I don't play them so much, and so I just naturally think the worst of them. Essage, I probably agree with part of that, but we're just not going to read it. Kara Dry said, Mike and David, you hit it on the head there. I'm sure he's talking about the instant zones, judging from where I am in the chat. Instances are trash. Yes. What about instance raid zones? Same opinion. Yeah, I think we hit on that. I think instance raid zones, I have the same, absolute same opinion as instant zones in general and different shards in general. Twin Cannon says, just wanted to give thanks for the strict policy of boxing since the topic came up. Boxing ruined live for me, and I've never seen a boxer on P99 yet. Twin Cannon, I am very sad to say that we absolutely have people that still two box on P99. And I know that our wonderful staff works daily on trying to send the message that we won't tolerate that. And you know what? It makes us feel real shitty when we have to suspend someone for 30 days because they did something stupid like logged on an alt to buff some their main character or logged on a druid to port their main character. And then we take their ability to play away for 30 days. And if it's a second offense, they lose the characters forever. I mean, that sucks. If it was me, I wouldn't even start over. I'd be so disheartened, I would just quit and go away. And then I'd forever be sad because I would have missed Velius. And you guys don't want to miss Velius. Micah, did you have anything to add about specifically instanced raid zones, raid bosses?
No, I think I pretty much said, you know, how it detracts from things.
Okay. At Sirkin. Oh, go ahead.
I know, I was going to say, I like the FTE. I like the foot race. I like the rush to see who gets there first.
I loved racing for mobs. Racing for raid targets, like actual racing like through a dungeon for a target, was some of the most fun I ever had. Even outdoor targets, like you could race for Lodzal, you can race for Sev. The problem is people, they literally... They would sit on the spawn spots for all week long if we let them. And if it was up to me, in a magical, perfect, unclassic world, all spawn, raid boss spawn timers, they would be completely random. And not only would they be completely random, the outdoor raid targets, like your Sev, your Talendor, your Gore, all those things, they would have random spawn spots too. So it would be literally impossible to poop sock these mobs, and it would always be a race. Racing through Sebulus can be so fun, but nerds just can't do it without training. And so we end up with mages sitting on Poop Mountain just waiting, just waiting so that they can spam Call of the Hero and start bringing their nerd pals in. And it's like, how is that fun? How is it fun to spam Call of the Hero and duck for 8 hours, 16 hours, because that's what raidings come to? Like, that's retarded. I know some guilds, they'll set up Bind Sight on something so that they have eyes on the spawn spot, and then they'll get that person in a Skype call with screen share, and you just add people to the group. And that way you can play your character, but you still have eyes on the spawn spot. And you're not technically toolboxing because you only have one character logged in game. You're just sharing screens with a friend on Skype. And now you have eyes on the mob target spot, and the actual person in-game, he doesn't even have to be there. He can be AFK, sleeping, out, drinking, doing whatever he wants, all night long. But as long as he's got that screen share set up, anyone who's in the group can see the spawn. And holy shit, I would never do that. I would never do that. Gerber Nils, you make me laugh. Oh, we have a lot of words here from Troa Death. Kind of funny, you said one week that you hated the raid scene so much you would not be doing this anymore if it weren't for your relationships with the rest of the staff, when the obvious and great solution is instancing. With that said, I do understand that people have all their pixels already and can only get a rush from the race. That's not what I like about raids. I'm not about competing. I just want to bullshit with my friends and get pixels. That's what EQ is all about, not poop sucking. I will agree that EQ shouldn't be about poop sucking, but I will adamantly disagree with you insofar as EverQuest not being a competitive game. PvP servers are obviously more competitive, but in a world without instancing and in a world where one guild can monopolize content, it is absolutely competition if you want mobs. I don't care how badly, like say Micah for example, I don't care how badly he wants to kill Trachanon. If he's not willing to compete against other guilds, he's probably not going to kill Trachanon. I don't even think there is a class R rotation anymore. So no, that's not even a thing. Maybe in between lockouts of certain big guilds, you get a shot, but. To say it's not competitive would imply that you can just show up and get your loot and go home. And that is not the case. There are other guilds adamantly going for the same target as you. And you have to compete against them to get said target. I feel that's the definition of competitive. Oh, Bracknar!
Yo!
Do you think EverQuest is a competitive game?
Not from where I'm sitting, but I'm not in the raid scene. I think it certainly could be.
All right. Well, I forget. Sometimes I forget how casual you are.
I am the dirtiest of dirty casuals. Mm. I could see it being competitive just because you can sort of envision, like you said, you know, the race for the mobs. You got, you know, without instancing. I still do see it. You know, I deal with camp disputes all the time, and it's the same kind of thing, just on a smaller scale.
Yeah.
I mean, a fewer rules, I suppose, you know. Here's a good PSA as far as camp disputes, something that people don't seem to understand. I've had folks, actually one this week, to try to claim that he could claim the entire Ancient Cyclops spawn in OOT as a camp. So folks know, you know, you cannot claim an outdoor. That just doesn't happen. Alex Sergen can correct me.
Time out. OOT is absolutely campable.
Well, no, but you can't just claim the entire island and be like, all ACs are mine.
Well, there's only one AC spawn on AC Island in OOT.
Yeah. Maybe it wasn't ACs. Maybe he was camping something that had multiple spawns, because I know I asked,
are you camping?
Maybe that. I said, are you camping a spawn point? And his first answer to that was no. And that's kind of where I was going to get to.
Yeah.
You could certainly camp a spawn point.
Yeah.
You could not camp an area. No, I'm sorry. It was South Row. It was ACs and South Row.
That's okay. What it was. Yes.
Because there's three spawns for ACs and South Row.
Right.
And so that's why I tried to explain to him that, you know, you can camp a spawn point, you cannot camp an area like that. And that doesn't seem to be too, like, a lot of people seem to understand that, but just wanted to throw it out there since we were kind of touching
on it. If you're by yourself, you should camp the thing in OOT, or the AC in OOT. If you're got four people, you should do it in South Row. It works. The South Row AC works exactly the same Quillmane in South Karana. You can be killing placeholders all you want, but you're clearly not sitting on Quillmane's spawn spot, and so that mob is first to engage. And if you go there by yourself, you really have to hope that some asshole doesn't come and steal the mob that you've been trying to pop. That's why a lot of the bigger guilds and guilds with lots of people, they will send a group to South Karana, and they'll have trackers running around, and they'll have people on the spawn spots, and they'll lock that whole thing down because they know it is FTE.
Yeah, I had one of those too pretty recently, where this guy was really upset because he'd been killing the placeholders and doing the rotation, and then someone came and took the kill. I was like, no, that's not how this works.
Yeah, I actually had to suspend somebody recently for kill stealing the Ancient Cyclops in Ocean of Tears.
Huh. Yeah, that happens.
I don't like suspending people. Stop making me do it.
So yeah, I could totally see how, you know, it is and can be competitive. It doesn't have to be. Like, that's the other thing I've been trying to enforce when I do have to deal with these disputes. Talk to freaking people. You know, I would say the vast majority of camp disputes I deal with, the first question is, have you talked to the other guy? And the answer is almost always no. And it's like, well, if you talk to the guy, it's kind of the same thing with in real life, right? Say you have neighbors that play their music really loud. And I've had this. I get so much better reaction when I just go there and be like, hey, dude, can you just turn it down after 10 o'clock? Yeah, man, no problem. You know, it's so much better when two people work together instead of one, you know, calling staff to come over and deal with them or something, because no one's going to like what happens when the staff guy gets involved. You know,
That's a pretty great analogy.
It is. And I think it holds true. Just, you know, be a human to the other guy, and you're likely to get a human response back. Now, not all the time. I mean, I have had a few times when people did try to work with the other guy, the other party, and the other party either, you know, they claim the other party has told them to fuck off or F off or whatever. You know, not all the time.
I like it. Micah.
What's up?
Your guild is getting into the raid scene. How do you feel about from a competition point of view? Do you feel it's competitive? Do you feel it's not competitive? Give me your thoughts on that.
I absolutely think it's competitive. I think with the way the rotations are set up and lockouts and stuff, it's hard for newer guilds who are coming up to get into it. But there's always got to be room for compromise. People just got to work it out. Otherwise, you're going to have a lot of petitions.
As a Class R guild, I'm curious, do you guys feel like your only limitations are like your guild's limitations, or do you feel like you're being blocked out by other guilds?
I think it's
like, do you feel you can, really. Okay. Do you think if you could wave a magic wand, like, do you know like how you would fix that or make it better for guilds in your situation, or your guild even?
I think there just has to be a summit between the guild leaders and just hash it out. That's the way it used to be done on Povar. There was a raid council.
Yeah. Did you guys have like a straight up server rotation on Povar?
Oh yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
All the way through all the content.
That is something. My server was PvP. We didn't have a rotation. And I know, I'm pretty sure Rogan and Nilbog didn't have rotations on their servers either. Which is why, like, from a staff point of view, we're always like, shit ain't classic, bro. Because for us, it wasn't. But then for people like you that played on servers with it, completely, completely different experience. And sometimes we forget that.
Yeah, that's the, like, knowing that a mob is going to, or not a mob, but a boss is going to spawn and it's down within, you know, 3-6 seconds. It's interesting to me because it didn't used to be that way on Povar, the server that I used to play. You would see VS sitting up in a zone in KC for hours because it was somebody's turn.
Well,
not 6 hours. There was a limit. The council had like a limit on it from what I remember. If you didn't engage, you weren't ready, then it becomes a free-for-all.
I like that.
Well, now keep in mind, though, that happened 15 years ago. So all these nerds playing P99 now were 15 years younger, and they could get along better. I'm just leaving that out there.
I think most of the guild leaders then were adults.
I'm sorry. I couldn't resist.
There are
15
countries.
Years ago, I was 25.
15 years ago, I was 17? Yes. Math. Ha!
Yeah, and you're just a little younger than me, so I was probably about that. I'm not going to math right now.
I just mathed. Oh, all right. We're gonna jump into kind of like a speed round. So if you guys have questions, put @SirKenP99 in them because it highlights it on my screen. It gets my attention, and you should fire them off now. Yuckers, that's not really a question, but he plays a mage on P99 and it literally kills his soul that he's just a COH bot because the raid situation is so shitty. Yuckers, I played a mage on live, and let me tell you, it was shitty. It's always shitty for mages. You just summon things and you maybe nuke, but you'll probably get yelled at for wasting mana that could have been used to summon more modulating rods for clerics. Mages have a rough life as far as raiding goes in classic through Velius. Alaris says, hey, there are 40 days to go until Veles comes out. Has there been any further discussion of a class system, raid lockouts, etc.? I know you can't discuss anything, but I'm going to ask you anyway. So then you can say that there has been discussions, blah, 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 blah. We have not talked about it. We'll talk about it as it gets closer. There's no point of us talking about it right now. We'll just be undecided and decide to talk about it again later. We've already gone down that road.
Part of me really wants to troll everybody. Like, 2 days prior, Rogan really needs to put a message out to be like, yeah, we're going to push it out till December.
Oh, God.
And heads would just explode.
It'd be better if, like, our release date was, like, in April, like, April 10th or 9th. And then we could just put it out, like, 12, like, real early in the middle of the night as it turns to April 1st and be like, yeah, sorry, we fucked up, no Veles. I still think the best April Fool's troll was the fake guises. Rogan and Nilbog set it up so everyone who logged in had a Guise of the Deceiver on their in their inventory. And when you clicked it, it just poofed and was like, April Fool's. I got excited. Olaris wants to know why the Red Server hates me so much. You know why? Because they've known me for too long and I've just banned too many of them and they're all upset about it. We answered all that. Hello, Nyx. Melander says Nilbog will tell you that on Emar we had a rotation for VS and Trachanon. I mean, we kind of have specific. We have a sky rotation, like that's a one specific thing. And if guilds want to get together and try to hammer something out, they absolutely can. But as far as I know, there was a guild rotation within Class R, and then it went to shit because guilds were not able to stay on friendly communication terms. Even though countries in real life at war killing people can still talk and communicate, our guild leaders can't. Author Christopher wants to know, when Veles comes out, do you believe there will be enough of the lower level community to keep around to keep the lower level zones alive, or do you think most part will become ghost towns, blah 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 blah? I don't think so at all. I'm not worried about that. I expect so many new players to come with Veles and so many old players to return that I absolutely expect the lower level things to be popping, especially everything under level 35.
We're still riding the wave from the Daybreak announcement, I think. We had, like, what, 50 people in Greater Faedark there for a while?
We'll get more people from Veles than we will from that.
I have no doubt.
But, yeah, I mean, things above level 35, obviously people are going to hit Veles zones because it's new content. No Emu server has had legit classic Veles as long as I've been around, and I've been around the EQ Emu community since 2007. I've seen many servers promise Veles. I've seen many servers even attempt to deliver Veles. Like, they've put it out, but it was just garbage. And we have a really, really amazing dev team, and they work together really well, and they've put a lot of time and a lot of effort into making Veles as good as it is. And I think you guys are all going to be very, very impressed, and hopefully you think and feel it was worth the wait. It has been a long time, but we don't want to give you a piece of shit like every other emulated server has done that's tried releasing Veles. Because, like the rest of it, we want to do Veles better than everyone else on the internet, too. Bullpina91 wants to know, do we have to download a patch or what when Veles drops? Do we as players have something to play? Wait, when Veles drops, do we as players have to do something to play new content? I don't believe so. I believe, look, here's what I'm going to say. Don't quote me on this. This is just me brainstorming out loud. But I'm pretty sure the server won't, you won't have to download anything. We're just going to flip a switch. And at that point, Veles or things will happen that will begin Veles. And if we had to sneak in files, we would do it ahead of time. We wouldn't do it right before Veles launch. You won't even know what's happening. It would be like going to the doctor as a dog. You just go and things happen. Sorry, excuse me. Sirkin, from a very high level, what makes delivering Velius so difficult for EMU servers? It's just all messed up. The pathing's messed up. The itemization's messed up. The mobs aren't all there. Some of the future expansions added quests and items and mobs to previous zones. And so devs have to comb through all that shit to get all that out. They also have to go through and recreate pathing in a lot of places. I know Nilbog put a ton of time and effort into making sure all of the like little scripted events within Velius function and work properly. And I've seen a couple of those, and I think it's awesome. Also, little things like in Thurgadin, you have all those dwarves that have their rooms, and they all go to like that council room and stand on those two ledges for a while, and then they all walk back to their rooms. Like, we want to make all that shit work. I don't have all the info, and I'm not the best person to talk about what it takes to make Velius Velius. And if I ever get Nilbog back on here, I'm going to ask him that question. And you should come back just in case I do have Nilbog on here, because you know what? I probably won't even remember to ask him, but he can give you a much, much, much better answer than I can. That's the question we just already do. Alaris, you're actually wrong. Velius is not on the P99 server, because if it was, as a GM, I'd be able to go there. Yeah. That's pretty much all I have. Micah, is there anything that we haven't touched on that you wanted to touch on or add on to or anything?
Well, let me look at my notes real quick. I kind of had butterflies before this all started. You got me all nervous.
I have that effect on people. It's like a first date. You gotta get all dressed up for me.
No, not really. I just wanted to give a shout out to some of the other streamers out there, because I did group with some of them leveling up. There's some in my guild, and
that's just actually
the community itself.
It's actually something I wanted to ask you. Who are some of the other streamers that you follow, that you watch, that you think are awesome, besides like you and besides you, who do you watch, who do you follow, who do you listen to? Like, give me a few names that you think are just really great streamers. I don't even care if it's P99.
Oh, I can go down the list of EverQuest streamers. You know, there's Upheaval from Anonymous Guild. There's
Upheaval's
Darth Craze.
Yeah, him too.
He was in and out. He's back now, I think. You think he's got the bug?
That is
Green Grocer. I love Green Grocer. I love his setup. I love his music. It's really good.
Have you ever seen his bum fights?
Oh, God.
No, I haven't. I've seen the forum posts.
Does he still do those?
I think he's trying to put another one together. I'm giving him my full support on it.
There's Uncle Bugsy. You know, he's more of a casual player. He's on a lot during the day.
Mm-hmm.
Other streamers out there, though, that aren't even related to P99. Like I mentioned, H1Z1, the zombie survival game that I play. OpSec, he's a great streamer. It's Macau. I mean, Twitch is a great thing, and it still boggles my mind how many players don't know about Twitch and what it can be used for and the advantages of it and how it can help build the community.
I do one stream a week. Sometimes I'll sneak like something else in there. But for the most part, I do one stream a week. And the sole purpose is to try and raise some awareness about P99 and let people, you know, people are just cruising the Twitch channels. They see EverQuest. They see a bunch of people watching EverQuest channel. They're like, what's this? They see classic troll models. They get all excited. And next thing you know, we hopefully have a new player on P99. I mean, that's one thing you can never stop doing. Always got to keep raising awareness in new places and doing new things, because there are so many people that want classic EverQuest but don't know it exists here.
Well, by the looks of the flow of the IP exemptions, we're still getting a ton of new players pretty constantly.
Oh, yeah.
And this is just the ones that are looking for IP exemptions. I mean, I'm sure there's many others that are not, but you know, that's still a pretty dang steady flow, such that if I don't go and run them at least every 2 days, I get like 20 or so behind, you know. Oh, that was one thing I was going to mention. Sirkin, did you see like that what was that Euro? That's that like German, I think, gaming thing that they. I kind of never got a chance to circle back with them. Did you see that though? The conversation we had
about with who?
It was like a German like LAN. There's some sort of a LAN event going on.
Oh no, it, no, I never. I dude, I'm, I don't know I'm if it's okay so to mention, buried. Like, in, don't mention the name.
Yeah, yeah, that's why I'm not. But at any rate, so they, it was really a cool situation, right? We get this request, and they asked for like 12 IP exemptions, which normally we're just like, oh my God, what, you know, are you on crack? Yeah. But the reasoning was they had, they were going to have like this, this LAN event, right? At this, I think it was like a gaming, kind of like an internet cafe, but for gaming. I don't know if anybody was from the 90s that remembers internet cafes. But any rate, it was a really cool thing. Like I had never seen anything like that done on P99. But I, what I really thought was interesting was that they chose to come to P99. They didn't do a let's go to Ragefire. They wanted to come to P99, and I thought that was just a really cool thing. I really do need to circle back with them and see if they got any. I was asking if they're going to be streaming it. They, I don't think any of them were streaming, but he said they were going to take pictures, and so I'd like to see some of the pictures just because it just seems like a fun little thing.
I like it. Guess what? We're out of time. Bracknar, out of time. Say goodbye to these people.
Goodbye, everybody.
Goodbye, everybody. Micah. Twitch.tv/MicahDavith. That's MicahDavith. If he says something in the chat room, that's your cue to type something in the chat room. If he says something in the chat room, you could just click on his name and then you could click on the follow button. It's made real easy for you. He streams almost every day. It's a stream that I watch that I really enjoy. And Micah, again, thank you for streaming P99. And thank you for being my guest on this very fine evening. I would say goodbye to these people. Give any last plugs you need to plug. And yeah.
Well, again, thank you, Sir Ken, for having me on the stream tonight. Thank you to all the people who work on Project 99 or 1999, keeping it up and running. Those donations you guys probably still need, and that's another tie-in with Twitch, you know, exposure, more people coming to the server. That's more donations for you guys, hopefully.
Yep. Unfortunately, monthly bills just keep coming every month. They don't give any shits.
Shout out to Anonymous Guild. You know, I'm loving it here. Great guys. And to all the other streamers again that I mentioned earlier. Thanks to the community, and I hope to see you guys around.
A plus. Again, Mike, thank you very much for coming on. And for everybody... Oh, you know what, guys? I'm going to put you on hold. So you can hang out or you can just hang up. But if you hang out, we can chit-chat a little bit afterwards. But for now, you're going on hold. Everybody, I'm Sirkin. Thank you so much for listening. Click the follow button. It'll let you know when I do things. I stream Monday nights, 10 p.m. Eastern. Sometimes I sneak little things in there. I don't really advertise it or broadcast or anything, so follow button. If you miss things and you want to catch up on them or you want to see the old things, www.youtube.com/circump99. It has all the things. That's it. Thank you guys so much for watching and listening and hanging out. We really do appreciate you guys, and I don't know if you know this or not, but we are only still doing this because you guys still watch it. So as long as you watch it and like it, we're going to keep making them. And hopefully, Comcast willing, we will see all of you next week. See you guys.